When you copy a file in Windows, for example, did you know that there's actually around 15 different data formats that are added to the clipboard behind the scenes? And this varies depending on what you copy. So for example, you copy an image in Google Chrome, it actually copies it in PNG, as bitmap, so different programs can handle different types. And by the way, if you're curious about this program that I'm using, it's actually one that I created myself and I've been working on. It lets you see a whole bunch of info about what's in the clipboard and even lets you edit the clipboard contents at the raw level. It's not quite finished yet, and it's not the main point of this video. I just knew people would ask, so I'll put the link in the description if you want to check it out anyway. Anyway, for this video though, I did have a thought. You know, is there actually a limit to the number of items that can be on the clipboard at once? And would anything interesting happen if you hit such a limit? And it turns out the answer to both of these is yes. As you'll see in a second, when it fills up, things all over Windows just start to kind of break. Just as a little teaser, a couple examples are that drag and drop no longer seem to work. Programs like Microsoft Edge starts throwing errors about no more system resources, and a lot of other fun stuff. And depending on the circumstance, it's not always just a matter of clearing the clipboard to fix it. Depending on how it was done, it could actually require you to restart the computer for it to fix. Now, as a quick crash course for some context, so you know what the heck I'm talking about and why these things are happening, I'll try to keep it simple. You don't really have to memorize all this or anything, but it'll help you understand. Basically, things on the clipboard are gonna have three main parts. There's the format name, the ID number, and the data itself. And looking at these, you might notice that a lot of the ID numbers are around the same. And there is a reason for that that you'll see in a second. When a program goes to add something to the clipboard, usually it's gonna add multiple things, and it has to actually technically specify the ID number of the format, not the name of it. The thing is that these ID numbers do not actually stay the same for each format name. It changes on restart. Everything gets reset. Now, there are a few so-called standard clipboard formats that do have the same name, but for the most part, you reboot your computer, it's all reset. Anyway, the way that these names get assigned to these IDs is the application has to request to register the name, it's called. So it basically tells Windows, I want to register this format name, and then if the name is already registered, it'll hand back the ID number, or if it's a newly registered one, it'll also hand back the number so it knows what to use to actually add to the clipboard. Because again, when you add to the clipboard, you have to use the number. Now, the reason this is relevant is because there is not an infinite number of these registered format slots. You can actually seemingly add data to any format ID number in that range, but to register a format and name it, so it's actually useful, it has to be between the 49,152 and maximum range. That's the allocated range, and that's just because when you do go request it, that's where Windows starts it at. You can't choose what number you get. And the way Windows chooses it is it simply counts up from that lower number. And the next one that is available, that's what gets assigned at the time it gets registered request. And that explains why the format IDs of all the ones we saw before were pretty much the same, because they were probably registered around the same time. So they were right next to each other. Now, to be clear, registering a format name does not add it to the clipboard. It just kind of reserves it as a name for later. And even after the application closes, it will stick around until the computer reboots. So now that you understand all that, we can get to the fun part. And I'm gonna start breaking things in two different ways. First, we can see what happens when you register too many formats. You fill up all the registrations, there's nothing left. And then we can see what happens if you simply fill up the clipboard and add too much stuff to it in general. Of course, I'm gonna be doing this in a sandbox so I don't mess up my main machine. Although funny enough, the first time I tried this, I forgot that the Windows sandbox by default shares the clipboard with the host. So yeah, a bunch of the clipboard stuff leaked out and I had to end up restarting my computer because it messed things up. Now, unfortunately, something else that's leaking all over the place is all your personal data being sold by sketchy online data brokers. But the way to stop it is today's sponsor, DeleteMe, a data privacy service to which I myself have been a paying customer for over 3 years now, long before they ever sponsored. If you have ever Googled yourself, you definitely have seen the countless so-called data broker websites who not only collect and display all your personal information like name, address, and phone number, but then go and sell it to a bunch of companies to do whatever they want with it. And this also makes it easier for malicious people to find and use your own info against you, like in phishing attacks and more. But that is where DeleteMe comes in. They do all the work for you in submitting removal requests on your behalf. New data brokers pop up all the time, so DeleteMe is constantly adding new ones, and they continue to monitor them and repeat removals if your info shows up on site again, which can happen a lot. At the moment, they automatically scan 132 data brokers, and you'll get a privacy report for which sites you were removed from after 7 days and every 3 months after that, so you can see exactly which sites are clean and which ones have removals in progress. But you can also submit custom requests to remove any data from hundreds of other websites, even surprising ones. The example I always give is berkeley.edu. It's not even a data broker, but DeleteMe will still help you get removed from there if you're on there for some reason. So if you want to get your personal information removed from the web and search results, go to joindeleteme.com/TheoJoe and use the promo code TheoJoe for a nice discount. And with all that being said, let's continue. All right, so we are in the sandbox, and I actually just whipped up a command line program to kind of let me spam the clipboard to do all this testing. And for a quick preliminary example, you can see that I'll have it add 100 items just from 1 to 100. And then using my other app that I showed before, we can see that these actually did get added. And you'll notice that these show as having names. That's because these are standard pre-added clipboard formats that are built into Windows, and it doesn't recognize that this data is just random that the app added. So it thinks it's actual clipboard format, but still it added it. So first, what we can do is fill up all the registration slots, because to actually add anything to the clipboard with a format ID in the registered range, it has to be registered first. You can't just add it to anything in there. You can actually do that for the standard ones, which you'll see in a second. And actually, real quick, I can show you in my other program, it lets you export a list of pre-existing registrations. And we can see there's quite a few, there's like hundreds. And a lot of it's just random Windows stuff. There's stuff that has to do with specific Windows apps. I'm not really sure what any of this is, but all of this is there for some kind of purpose. And that will be relevant when things start glitching out. It'll explain some things. So we'll just have it spam the full maximum possible amount, 16,384, and then it'll add as many as it can. I can enter the range, and I just have min and max preset as ranges. And there it goes. It goes pretty fast. And once it runs out, it starts saying failed, but that's because it reached the end. And then I'll run this other command I have that also lists out all the registered formats. And you can see now it is filled to the brim with just custom format and a bunch of numbers all the way to the maximum. Though you'll notice it actually only goes up to 16,320, which is not the number you might expect, which would be 16,384. And that is because it turns out for some reason, every 256 numbers, you can't register those formats, including 49,152, the first one. So there's actually 64 of such numbers in the list. So you minus that, you get 16,320. So indeed, every single possible registered format ID is taken. Now, already things are going to be broken. It turns out that programs really do not like when they cannot register their clipboard formats. For example, if you try to open Microsoft Edge, like I showed you, it says that the system has run out of resources. Even though if you look in the task manager, for example, you can see there's plenty of RAM left. So it's not talking about RAM, it's talking about the clipboard formats. Also, you can seemingly, in this case, no longer drag and drop in File Explorer. And actually, a lot of this behavior will come down to whether or not you did that thing before you filled up all the clipboard formats. For example, if I filled everything up before right-clicking in File Explorer, I'm not gonna be able to right-click because apparently it needs to register something to right-click. But like I said, if I restart the sandbox and then right-click beforehand and then run it again, it actually does let me right-click. And I can now even hit copy, although for some reason it won't let me paste, so things are still weird. If Microsoft Edge happened to be launched beforehand, it actually will launch this time, but it won't load. It just shows like a white window, and you drag the size, it looks all weird, it doesn't seem to be drawing properly, very odd. And even my app, if I hadn't launched it before, if I try to run it, it'll either show an error or just not run at all. Probably because it uses the .NET framework from Microsoft that's built into Windows behind the scenes. There's even more weird things, like if you try to open the settings app, that's not gonna open at all. No errors, just doesn't open. Even the task manager, if you didn't have that running beforehand, it won't open. But now let's cause even more havoc, because remember, that's just all the registering of the formats. That doesn't even have a bunch of stuff in the clipboard itself. So let's just see what happens if we fill up the clipboard with random data, about 32 bytes randomly in every format from 1 to 65,000, if it'll at least get up to that. Strangely, it does seem to get most of the way there, around 51,000 items added, and then it just fails for the rest. But I don't think it's just that range, because if I have the clipboard cleared, and then I just go from like 49,000 to the end, it'll do all of those. So the 51,000 thing seems to be significant somehow. And I do have a command that lets me see the actual number on the clipboard as a separate command, so there is actually this many on there. It's not like it just says it added them. And now things are just starting to bug out even more. For example, Windows Explorer crashes pretty frequently. Now, I figured since a lot of the issues at this point is just from the registration, not the amount of items, I restarted the sandbox to clear all the registrations and then had it add clipboard items from the 1 to like 49,000 range, because you can actually add things in that range without registering at all. And that's still pretty close to the 51,000 we were at before anyway. So at this point, I can see that Windows Explorer still is crashing. It seems to crash whenever you try to open a window. And funny enough, even simply trying to right-click anything in Explorer also causes it to crash, probably because it's trying to look to see if there's anything it can paste and it's just choking on it. And unsurprisingly, Control-V also causes it to crash and like restart the desktop. But interestingly, despite all this, technically the clipboard does still work. For example, in Edge, if I right-click a text box, it'll actually give me an option to paste the random data. It thinks it's Unicode characters, it's just random data, but it does see it, probably because it's just looking for the first item. And you can even paste it, and it does work. However, if you try to do Control-V anywhere, it must check for more, and it just immediately crashes Edge, so you can't do that. So basically, it seems that anything that has to try and look through what's in the clipboard is not going to be expecting that. It's going to freak out and probably freeze or crash or time out or something. But the good news in this case is that since the problem is simply the number of things on the clipboard, it can be fixed by clearing the clipboard. So if I do the command for that in here, everything's back to normal. It works like normal. So I would be curious to know what of this you guys knew already. Did you know there was all this stuff in the clipboard and there was so much depth to it? Again, I'll in the future make a video going into more detail about probably secrets of the clipboard or something like that, but this is just a fun experiment. Thanks again to DeleteMe for sponsoring. And again, if you want to have your personal information removed from data brokers, go to joindeleteme.com/TheoJo and use the promo code TheoJo for a nice discount. So if you enjoyed the video, be sure to give it a big giant thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm. And if you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I talked about Windows generic keys. Are they illegal? You know, those keys you find all over the internet. I'll put that link right there you can click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.